Hi everyone, can you imagine a world without words? How can we communicate then? We know all humans speak at least one language. The words we speak bring out our thoughts. Here you have a poem to learn. The name of the poem is The Wonderful Words. It's written by Mary O'Neill. She was an Irish poet and dramatist and a friend and colleague of W.B. Yeats, George Russell, Austin Clark. She was born on August 3, 1879. Her famous works are Long Songs of Connacht, Hi Uncle Sam, Meeting the British, D-Day, Prayer Before Birth, etc. This poem is all about the role and importance of language and language skills to shape the ideas of the mind. Dear friends, without any further delay, let's begin our poem, The Wonderful Words. Never let a thought shrivel and die for want of a way to say it. For English is a wonderful game. Shrivel means to wither or shrink, wrinkle and contract. Wonderful, wonderful. What is the meaning of wonderful? Extremely good, marvelous, inspiring, delight. Game, all of you know that. It is used here for enriched language. Here game is used for enriched language. Okay. Here the poet is saying that never let any idea or thought die. In other words, never let it go without giving it expression. Just because you don't know how to speak or how to use the right words. English is a very rich language full of treasures. Okay, see the next lines. And all of you can play it. All that you do is match the words to the brightest thoughts in your head so that they come out clear and true and handsomely groomed and fed. For many of the loveliest things have never yet been said. Handsomely, that means elegant style, attractive manner. Okay, groomed and fed, nurtured. Okay, play here means use. The poet says that all of you can play it, which means everyone can use it effectively. You can find the perfect words for the thoughts or ideas in your head and give it a clear expression so that people can understand it clearly and nicely. Don't think that you cannot do it. There are yet many good things, the most beautiful ones, which have not been said and done just because of lack of nurturing, lack of words and knowledge. The poet is laying stress on learning a language correctly and completely. Okay, see the next lines. Words are the food and dress of thought. They give it its body and swing. And everyone's longing today to hear some fresh and beautiful things. But only words can free a thought from its prison behind your eyes. Maybe your mind is howling now. A marvelous new surprise. Marvelous means amazing. Okay, words give a structure to any thought or idea in our mind. The poet is saying that never think that we do not have any new thoughts. They are yet to be explored and searched. They yet need to come through. Thoughts and ideas are caged in our minds. If anything can set them free, that is words. Words alone can give clear and beautiful expression to thoughts and ideas. Words alone can earn them praise. So it's a must to learn and perfect our language. In this poem, what does the poet want to express? What would have been the scenario if there was no language, he's asking. How would we communicate with each other? Words are what help us to express our thoughts and ideas. The poet says that if you have any thought or idea, but you don't know how to say it, just pick up the words that will express that thought or idea the best way possible. Man is a gifted animal, the poet says. Man is a gifted animal who can think and speak. Every man knows at least one language, as it is a must to give expression to thoughts, ideas, and feelings. Isn't it? All people think as well as speak. The poet advises the readers to work on their language and learn it skillfully. The poet says that we all know one language at least. We all have a mother tongue. So we must have good command over it. We shouldn't let any idea go or fade just because we don't find the right words for it. Rather, conscious effort should be made to find words to express it clearly. It might be possible that idea does wonders. English is a wonderful and rich language. One can express one's thoughts in this language without any hassles, clearly and flawlessly. The need is to look for the correct and right words to express our ideas clearly. It's wrong to think that there are no more good thoughts left to be expressed. The most beautiful way to give expression to our thoughts or ideas is our words. Everyone loves to hear new and good things. The only thing is that we need to master the language and find the right words. Everyone's thought is like a prisoner or a caged bird in our mind. We can set that idea free with the help of words. It's quite possible that the thought may be marvelous. So the poet here tried to convince us to learn well or to be a master in at least one language. Then we can express our ideas and thoughts to others flawlessly. Okay. So my dear friends, you should learn at least one foreign language. It will make you smarter. You know, people who speak a second language are seen as educated, intelligent, cultured, and sociable. Do you know that? Then learning a foreign language will improve your memory. Because research shows that people who speak several languages are better at memorizing. Why? Your brain is like a muscle. The more you use it, the stronger it becomes. Studying a foreign language makes your brain muscle stronger because you are memorizing lots of words, verbs, or a list of words and grammar rules, etc. Okay, then it will help you understand another culture better. Do you know that? Then you will feel satisfied. Then you will become more perceptive. Then speaking one more language will facilitate your travels abroad. You know, then you will be better at making decisions. You will start seeing the world in a different way. Then you will get better at writing also. So, my dear children, be professional and learn at least one second language rather than our mother tongue. Okay? See you in the next class. Thank you.